Hello, I'm Jared, back with another demonstration experiment on the water cycle. We're gonna make it rain inside, and that's a cool thing. And it may seem like a lot of materials, it's very simple, very user-friendly, very easy, and we can make it rain inside. We want kids to be able to see the water cycle work. So I have a pan full of water, I heated it on the burner. I don't know if you can see the steam coming off. We wanted to speed up the evaporation process. So instead of the sun heating the water from above, the coil is heating the water from below, making it evaporate. So evaporation, easy. But the cool part about evaporation is it cleans and cleanses the water. So I want to make this water dirty. I could spit in it, things like that. I'm just going to put some red food coloring, some blue food coloring. You could put in dirt, you could put in vinegar. I'm gonna put some salt in, you could put in sugar. You can see, plenty of salt. And I have a soupy, dirty mess in there. I would not wanna pick that thing up and chug it down. It's dirty, but that's what's cool about the water cycle. We can take this mess and purify it, clean it. We need all the water cycle to do it. So, here we go. All of that liquid in there is starting to evaporate. What I need to do is I need to be able to condense that water vapor in this air. How do I do it scientifically? I need something cold and I need the water to condense onto something. So I have this pan. How do I make the pan cold? Put some ice in it. So let's rip the bag open. Let's put some ice in. The ice is gonna melt, form a nice cold layer of water. Now, I'm gonna hold my cloud, my layer of cold air, over this water vapor, and you're going to see this pan actually start to fog up. What's going on? Well, as that water vapor is hitting that cold pan, it wants to condense back into a liquid, and it's starting to condense into a liquid. And as more water vapor hits, all of those tiny droplets of water get bigger and bigger as more water condenses onto it. You can actually see it. And we're gonna give it some time, but actually enough water is gonna condense on the bottom of this pan. It's gonna rain, it's gonna precipitate. And the cool thing is, I'm gonna lick this pan. It's not gonna taste like salt. Why? All the dirt's left down in the pan. That's the cool thing about the water cycle. It cleans all the water. It's an amazing design. So to show you that the water on this pan, we brought in a little light and we're gonna angle the dish. I normally wouldn't do this, but just so you can see the water condensing onto the pan, and you're gonna see it precipitate. So here we go, let's angle this, try to keep the ice in the pan. And if you'll see the water dripping down, it's not dripping, it's raining, folks. That's the scientific term. We have water evaporating, hitting the cold air, or the cold pan, condensing onto that. That water droplet gets so heavy that it rains, it precipitates. That's the beauty of the water cycle. Thanks for watching.